So today we're going to talk about low blood pressure and a few related conditions. One being something called POTS. POTS stands for postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome. Now I know you know what posture means, but what about this term orthostatic? It's a term to describe upright posture. So postural orthostatic hypotension is used to describe a condition where you're lying down and then you stand up and your blood pressure drops. But not only does your blood pressure drop, your pulse rate starts going up, you feel dizzy, disoriented, you can lose your sense of vision, you can feel lightheaded, fatigue, nauseous, blurred vision, shakiness, fainting, and you can actually go unconscious. Now your normal blood pressure should be 120 over 80. Now low blood pressure or hypotension is defined being the systolic number or the top number being less than 90 and the bottom or diastolic being less than 60. Now I also want to mention when people go into shock, the first thing that happens is their blood pressure drops right down. And this could occur from being overheated, overtraining, loss of blood, taking certain medications, trauma, and the list goes on and on. But what I want to focus on this video is mainly the mechanism of what occurs when you stand up and your blood pressure drops. What's behind this and what can you do about it? So what are the possibilities? Well, number one, it could be that you just don't have enough blood in your body. And that can come from various things, internal bleeding. Another possibility could be that you're anemic. That could be from low iron. Another common reason for not enough volume of blood in your body is you're dehydrated because you don't have enough salt. Salt helps you retain fluid. And this can show up a couple ways. Number one, just not consuming enough salt. Number two, drinking excessive amount of water without the salt can severely dehydrate you because all this water is going to dilute the last bit of sodium you have and severely dehydrate you. And so you can be dehydrated by consuming too much water without the salt. The salt is there to help you retain the fluid. One interesting point about this is when someone starts the ketogenic diet, they lose a lot of fluid because they're no longer retaining fluid. And so people, when they start the ketogenic diet, should actually consume a little more salt. Now, if you are taking diuretics, if you have vomiting, if you have dehydration, those could be other reasons why you don't have enough fluid in your body. And that can show up as low blood pressure. All right, so there's something else I want to talk about, and that relates to something called the autonomic nervous system. If your autonomic nervous system is not working right, if it's dysfunctional, that could be the reason why your blood pressure drops when you stand up, because the autonomic nervous system has everything to do with adapting your body to stress, especially postural stresses. So let's say, for example, this is your body and you have your blood, right? And you lay down. So when you stand up, your blood's going to pull to the bottom of your body and your legs, right? Well, what's going to happen to your head up here if you don't have enough blood and oxygen is you're going to pass out. So the autonomic nervous system helps push or squeeze the blood up into your brain. That's what it does. So the autonomic nervous system is mainly located in the lower part of your brain called the brain stem. And your brain stem is very sensitive to a B1 deficiency. Why? Because you need B1 to handle the massive oxygen that the brain requires to do its function. B1 is like the spark plug in a carburetor where you're mixing oxygen and fuel. Without the B1, you won't get that combustion and you won't be able to use the fuel in your brain. So without B1, the brain doesn't work that well and the autonomic nervous system does not work that well. In fact, even when you're deficient slightly in B1, you can have very similar symptoms to POTS. For example, your pulse rate goes up, you can have arrhythmias, you get dizzy when you stand up. Now, the way that someone becomes deficient in B1 is mainly through consuming refined carbohydrates and sugars. They can also get it by consuming too many sulfites in red wine and also dried fruit, also malabsorption. So if you have a gut problem, it could be that you're just not able to absorb vitamin B1. And then also, when you start the ketogenic diet, the requirement for B1 goes way up. And if you're deficient, you're going to have symptoms, especially keto fatigue. And also, the more stress you have, the more B1 you're going to need. The other key nutrient for the autonomic nervous system is vitamin D. Without vitamin D, your autonomic nervous system is just not going to work that well. So, If you have POTS, if you have low blood pressure, three things that I would focus on is more salt, more B1 through nutritional yeast, and more vitamin D3.
Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.